Hi, I'm Tanya, and you are watching Dante Boxing Nation.
Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? So not only does Guillermo Rigondeaux return to the top of the coincidental list, but he returns to the throne. He is once again at the top at a lower weight class. He becomes champion in the second weight division, 118 pounds. This is unprecedented, guys, and the reason why it is, because not only did he make history becoming the oldest champion at 118, you know, it's recorded that he's 39. Some people will say that he's actually older than that, you know, when you consider the fact that a lot of Cubans that defect over here, they usually have a different age on their birth certificate that they actually give when they come over here to the States. I mean, don't get me wrong, he could be 39, but all we know for sure is he's at least 39 years old. And that's why this is so impressive. Rigo, he fought against Panama's Solis for the WBO vacant title, and Solis was no joke. He came in really rugged, really aggressive, and Rigo, in the first round, he wanted to show that he could fight right on the inside, and he got staggered a little bit in the first round. But after that, his trainer, Ronnie Shields, told him to go back to finesse and go back to boxing, and once Rigo started boxing, he looked beautiful. He made it look super easy. And then in the seventh round, he caught Solis and he hurt him really bad, got a knockdown, knocked him into the ropes, and then it was really all downhill from that point for Solis. It's time for some contrast. Now, I want you guys to really think about this. When it comes to Gennady Golovkin, you have fans saying that he's too old to fight the likes of a Demetrius Andrade or this guy or that guy. They were saying this when Golovkin was 36. But here, Rigo is at 39 or 40, regaining the title after he moved down three weight classes. And now he's calling out the monster, Inoue, which is equivalent to Gennady Golovkin calling out Demetrius Andrade or Jermall Charlo at age 37, at age 39, etc., etc. You follow me? Guys, this is what Rigo is made of. You know, people don't even realize this. After Rigo lost to Lomachenko, I have to say it again, he moved all the way down to 118 and regained a title. If you guys know the history of fighters moving up in weight, the vast majority of them, they stay at that weight class or they end up even moving to a higher weight class. Case in point, Mikey Garcia versus Errol Spence. Mikey moved up to 147. Now he's still fighting at 147. When Juan Manuel Marquez, when he moved up to fight against Floyd Mayweather, after that, Juan started to campaign at 147. Canelo, he moved up in weight from 154. Now he's fighting all the way at 175. He goes up and down, but he stays at the higher weight classes. He's not coming back down to 154. So my point is, this shows you how small Guillermo Rigo is. And it shows you the heart that Rigo has and the determination to try to prove that he's the best fighter in the world by moving up two weight classes to fight against a beast like Lomachenko. You know, it's different when you're moving up two weight classes to fight someone like a Roman Gonzalez. I'm talking about the Roman Gonzalez in his prime, not the one today. But it's different when you're moving up to fight someone like that, someone who's flat-footed, you know, doesn't have the best defense. But when you move up two weight classes to fight a two-time gold medalist who's already considered pound for pound one of the best fighters in the world, if not the best fighter in the world at the time, and then go back down to even a lower weight class, yeah, that's impressive, guys. That's impressive. And Rigo is still looking fresh. I mean, he's still looking like the 33-year-old Rigo. So I'll wrap this video up by saying congratulations to Guillermo Rigo. He regains form. He's back on top. And I look forward to seeing some really, really intriguing matchups. Speaking of that, I'm going to talk about the Inoue fight or a possible Inoue fight in my next video. That's all I got for now, guys. I'm on to the next one.